comfortable, as comfortable as you could be after being used to a place for a while. And I was getting along pretty good, but I was not free. I couldn't do what I wanted to do. I was not free. I was still confined. And you know, every day that I was in prison, I was reminded of my crimes, and I was reminded of my guilt. The guilt was there. It would not go away. And the bars, every time I would see the bars in front of me, I was reminded that I was not free. Even though I might have been a little comfortable, I was not free. Even though I was trying to be good, I was not free.
Amen.
And you know what? And then when I found out that I couldn't work my way out, I found out that I would never be able to pay my debt. Right? So one day, though, everything changed. A man from the outside came, and he told me that there was a person who had already paid my debt. And all I had to do was to admit to my guilt. And then I had to ask for forgiveness, and then I had to accept the payment on my behalf. I was overwhelmed, because when you're in prison, and you've been told there's no way out, and somebody comes to you and says, "I can get you out. This is all you have to do." I was pretty overwhelmed. And so I accepted the payment on my behalf. I mean, I was pretty overjoyed. I was like, who wouldn't? Who wouldn't accept this, right? So I did. I said, sure. So that day, I walked out of prison a free woman. And you know what? To make it even better, there were people who walked out with me. I did not walk out alone. It was all kinds of other people. And they were set free that day. And we walked out free people. Our debt paid, and we were joyous. But you know, looking back many, many years now, later, I'm still a free woman. I walk around and I'm free. But a lot of the people that walked out with me are not that way. Sad to say, some of them, when they got out of prison, they wanted to continue doing some of the things they had done in prison. Some of them were not model citizens. Some of them didn't care about working their way out. They just did what they wanted in prison, you know, and it was fun to them. So when they got out, they were struggling. They knew they had been released. They knew the debt that had been paid, and yet they wanted to continue to do the same things they had always done. But now it was different, because now they're on the outside and they're free. And when they did those things, their conscience pricked them. They would feel that in their heart. They knew what they were doing wasn't right. And so now, as I was getting uncomfortable living free, it was a little uncomfortable. And so they decided then to go back. All right? So you know what they did? They just turned around, walked back, walked into the cell, and shut the door.
Mm.
They did it. And they said, "Lock me in. This is where I want to be. This is my comfort zone. This is what I'm used to. This is where I get to do what I want to, and my conscience doesn't prick me anymore." So, you know, it's the craziest thing I ever saw. I thought, who in their right mind would want to put themselves back in the prison? Who would want to put themselves back in bondage after you've been set free, after somebody paid with their life to give you that opportunity to be set free? But you know what, it happens every day. Every day. And it may have happened to people that you know. Because all of you, were also in prison. Every one of you that sits here were in prison at one time. Your soul was in prison and it was not free. And Jesus came and set you free. And I guarantee, well, I say I guarantee, but I bet you most of you have known somebody that used to serve the Lord and then turned back and said, "No more, this is not what I want." And you know what? It may even be you. I don't know. You may be sitting there and looking back with longing, because you know what happens sometimes? You know, when you read about the Israelites, when I read about them, I think, man, these people were dumb. I mean, you really can't. I mean, you read about what God did for them and setting them free, and they were in slavery, and then just a little while sometimes to look back. And there comes a time in every Christian's life, and this is where the word sanctification will come in, but there comes a time in every Christian's life, God has set us free. And now we have to choose.